You're listening to the melding together of entertainment and enlightenment. It's raw and it's real. You're listening to the Outlaw Radio Network.
You are fined one credit for a violation of the verbal morality statute.
It is the inalienable right of every man
or woman,
to rid himself
or herself.
Agreed.
Thank you, brother.
Or sister.
Furthermore,
it is the birthright of every man
or woman.
Why don't you shut up about women, Stan? You're putting us off.
Women have a perfect right to play a part in our movement, Reg.
Why are you always on about women, Stan?
I want to be one.
What?
I want to be a woman. From now on, I want you all to call me Loretta.
What?
It's my right as a man. I want to have babies.
You want to have babies?
It's every man's right to have babies if he wants them.
But you can't have babies!
Don't you oppress me.
I'm not oppressing you, Stan. You haven't got a womb. Where's the fetus going to gestate? You're going to keep it in a box?
Suppose you agree that he can't actually have babies, not having a womb, which is nobody's fault, but that he can have the right to have babies.
Good idea, Judith. We shall fight the oppressors for your right to have babies, brother. Sister, sorry. What's the point?
What?
What's the point of fighting for his right to have babies when he can't have babies? It is symbolic of our struggle against oppression.
Symbolic of his struggle against reality.